solution of equation reducible to quadratic equation, which is related to exponential equations. So first we see what are exponential equations. Exponential equations are those in which variables occur in exponent, in which variable occurs in exponent form. Like you can take an example, if we have 3 raised to power 1 plus x plus 4 dot 3 raised to power minus x minus 7 is equals to 0. So this is an example of exponential equation because the variables occur in exponents. So now let's take an example and understand how we can reduce such equations to quadratic equation, and then we will find their solution. Okay, so this is, we have example number 1, 4 dot 2 raised to power 2x plus 1 minus 9 dot 2 raised to power x plus 1 is equals to 0. So now we will reduce this equation to quadratic equation. So see here, we have 4 dot 2x plus 1 minus 9 dot 2x plus 1 is equals to 0. Do remember one thing, when bases are same, we can add their powers. When bases are same, we can add their powers. So here you can see 4 dot, we have added the powers. It means if we want to split this term, we can write it as 2 raised to power 2x dot 2 raised to power 1. Since their bases are same, when we will add them, we will get this term. So now we have split it. Minus 9 dot 2 raised to power x plus 1 is equals to 0. Next, this is 2 raised to power 1, which means 2. So 4 multiplication with 2, it means 8. Dot 2 raised to power 2x minus 9 dot 2x plus 1 is equals to 0. Now here you can see we have 2 raised to power x, but here we have 2 raised to power 2x. To make this term similar to this term, what we will do is we will write 2 raised to power x raised to power 2, because when this 2 will multiply with this x, we will get 2 raised to power 2x minus 9 dot 2 raised to power x plus 1 is equals to 0. So now we have this term and this 2x term same. So we will put 2x is equals to some variable y. So now we will interchange 2 raised to power x with y throughout the equation, and we have 8y square minus 9, 2 raised to power x will be replaced with y, plus 1 is equals to 0. So now we will solve it. 8y square minus 9y plus 1 is equals to 0. So we will solve this equation by factorization method. So 8y square minus 8y minus y. When we will add them, minus 8 plus minus 1, we will get minus 9 this term. And when we will multiply minus 8 with minus 1, we will get 8, which is AC. So for factorization, we want two terms whose addition gives us B and whose multiplication gives us AC. So these are the two factors. Plus 1 is equals to 0. So now we will take 8y common. We have y minus 1. Now we will take minus 1 common. We have y minus plus minus 1 is equals to 0. So 8y minus 1, or we can say y minus 1 is equals to 0. So either 8y minus 1 is equals to 0 or y minus 1 is equals to 0. From here we have 8y is equals to 1. From here we have y is equals to 1. Y is equals to 1 over 8 and y is equals to 1. So these are the two values of y. But y is actually equals to 2 raised to power x. So now we will put y is equals to 2 raised to power x. 2 raised to power x is equals to 1 over 8. Now this is 2 raised to power x is equals to 1 over 8 can be written as 2 raised to power 3. 2 cube is equals to 8. So we can write 8 as 2 raised to power 3. 2x is equals to, now we will take this 2 raised to power 3 in the numerator and it will be like 2 raised to power minus 3. So now these bases are same. We can compare these two terms. So we have x is equals to minus 3. See here, we have 2x is equals to 1. We know that because 2 raised to power 0 is equals to 1. In fact, any constant raised to power 0, it means this is equals to 1. So we will replace 1 with 2 raised to power 0. Now we have same basis. We will compare these two terms and we have x is equals to 0. So the solution set of this question is minus 3 comma 0. So this is how we can solve an exponential equation and we can reduce it to quadratic equation. We have example number 2, 3 raised to power 2x minus 1 minus 12.3 raised to power x plus 81, and this is equals to 0. So first we will split this term and we have 3 raised to power 2x dot 3 raised to power minus 1 minus 12.3 raised to power x plus 81, and this is equals to 0. So this we can write as 3 raised to power x square dot 3 raised to power minus 1 minus 12.3x plus 81 is equals to 0. 3x square, this is 3 raised to power minus 1, which means 1 over 3. So we can write this 3 in the denominator. Minus 12.3x plus 81 is equals to 0. So we have to form an equation. So we will eliminate this 3 by multiplying 3 throughout the equation, throughout equation number 1. So 3 and 3 will be cancelled out and we have 3x raised to power square minus 12, 3 times is 36 into 3x plus 81 multiplication with 3, which means 243 is equals to 0. Now see here we have 3x. So we will put 3x equals to some variable y. Y square, replacing 3x with y, minus 36y plus 243 is equals to 0. Now we have to factorize this term. So we have to take two terms, minus 27 and minus 9. When we will add them, minus 27 plus minus 9, we will get minus 36 this term, and when we will multiply minus 27 with minus 9, we will get 243. So these are the two factors, y square minus 27y minus 9y plus 243 is equals to 0. Taking y common from the first two terms, we have y minus 27 minus, taking 9 common, we have y minus plus minus, and 9, 27 times is 243. You can check it. This is 243 divided by 9. So 9, 2 times is 18. We have 6 left, 63. So 9, 7 times is 63. So y minus 27, we will write one time. And we will write y minus 9 is equals to 0. So either y minus 27 is equals to 0 and y minus 9 is equals to 0. So from here we have y is equals to 27, and from here we have 9 is equals to y. Y is equals to 9. But our y is equals to 3x is equals to 27. So 3 raised to power x is equals to 27 can be written as 3 raised to power 3. 3, 3, 3. So 3, 3 times is 9, and 9, 3 times is 27. So we can write 27 as 3 cube. So now bases are same. We can compare these two terms and we have x is equals to 3. And here we have y is equals to 9. Which means 3 raised to power x is equals to 9. So 3 raised to power x is equals to 3 square. We can write 9 as the square of 3. 3, 3 times is 9. So the bases are same. We can compare their powers and we have x is equals to 2. So the solution set is 2, 3. So this is how we can solve an exponential equation and we can reduce it to quadratic equation.